All right, today we're going to talk about bile acid diarrhea. That's right, bile can cause diarrhea as a side effect because bile inhibits the reabsorption of water. And so too much bile can lead to diarrhea. So you would never want to take bile salts, including the gallbladder formula, if you have diarrhea, okay? Because that's just going to make it worse. Now, many times when people have their gallbladder removed, what happens is now they just have a duct from the liver to the small intestine. There's no gallbladder left. So there's really no way to regulate the amount of bile that's going into the small intestine because the gallbladder normally stores bile and then you eat and it contracts and it pushes bile into the small intestine every time you eat. But now there's just a duct. If that duct is too big and it's just draining too much, it can lead to a lot of complications. And then what will happen is your doctor will give you medication to block that so we don't have as much bile. Now, there's a couple other reasons why you might have diarrhea from bile because your liver makes bile. Those are called primary bile acids. But then also the intestine will make bile salts as well. But what's normally supposed to happen because your body is very, very efficient with bile, you're supposed to recycle 97% of all the bile that's going through the small intestine. It acts like a detergent that can actually kill microbes because normally you shouldn't have bacteria in your small intestine, just the large intestine. So it's supposed to kill everything through there and then get reabsorbed at the last part. It's called the distal part, the last little part of your small intestine. Okay. If there's damage within that part of the intestine, or you have ileitis, inflammation of the ileum, or you have some type of inflammation in that area, you're not going to reabsorb that bile. So therefore, you're going to have more bile than you really need, and that can create diarrhea. So this is why you might see this in IBS or even SIBO, which is small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, because the bile is not actually killing the microbes in the small intestine. So therefore, the microbes are now living there. They're growing and they're robbing your nutrition. And when you consume food, you're going to get a lot of bloating. So one thing you can do is get a stool sample to find out if this is what you have, because they can identify in the stool how much bile you have versus other things. The other thing you can do to slow down the diarrhea is to consume fiber. Fiber tends to bind with the bile and it will slow things down. I would highly recommend you do what's called low FODMAP vegetables. I'm going to put a link down below for more information on that, but that would be things like carrots, green beans, tomatoes, zucchini, spinach, radish, kale, cabbage, because certain foods that are high in FODMAP, which are certain types of carbohydrates that can create more bloating, are going to be worse for you. The other thing you want to cut down on is fat, because fat stimulates the bile production. So I just wanted to give you a couple of tips on this. If you have this condition, it can be very devastating, and there is some things you can do about it. Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it, and here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself. And so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.